Look up from your telescope. Take me on this journey home. I don't wanna wait no more. All right, y'all, I'm back with another video. And as you know, while we're on hiatus, I will be dropping new videos daily, Monday through Fridays. And we have our rewatches on Saturday of season one. So let's get into this heavy and hot topic, which is why the car crash is a very big problem. Okay, so it's all fun and games. I put up a post that asked you guys whose fault was the car crash, and then I created a subsequent video to really talk about it, just to kind of like have a conversation in jest, because we finally get our Spolivia moment in the end of episode 8, and it's all good, right? Aside from the fact that Olivia crashes the car and she happens to have alcohol in her system. The problem is that not only does she do this action, but then she chooses to not take responsibility for it, asking for Spencer to swap spaces with her so that he can take responsibility for it and she won't get into bigger trouble for driving under the influence. Now, I can already feel it. This video comment section is going to be lit. It's going to be a ton of debate, and I am aware that we have differences of opinion. I have actually pulled in comments for this video because I have already seen a ton of other comments underneath that previous video. If you have not watched that video, please go and check that out now and then come back to this video, because you do need to see my take on whose fault the car crash is, and then we build upon that in this video and actually get a little bit more serious and talk about why this car crash is a problem, and ultimately not just why the car crash is a problem, but why Olivia's ask of Spencer in this moment is a problem. Okay, so spoiler alert, y'all. The reason why Olivia asking Spencer to switch spaces with her is a problem, number one, is because it's selfish. Spencer is not drinking. Spencer is not driving. So for him to be asked by Olivia, and she knows that he's going to do it, to swap places with her so that she can avoid trouble, it's coming from a place of privilege. And it's coming from a place of privilege being from where she comes from. Olivia automatically thinks of how she can get out of situations, how the rules don't apply to her. And in this situation, y'all, whether y'all want to believe it or not, she is weaponizing her privilege and using it to be able to get out of potential trouble. In my opinion, this is not the Olivia that we have been seeing evolve over the last two seasons. This is not Speak the Truth podcast live. This is not woke live. This is not Black Lives Matter lives. This is Beverly Hills live, who is worried about herself and herself alone in this moment. I said what I said. Because while some of y'all might look at it like, oh, it's just a car crash, Spencer's just gonna get a ticket, it's no big deal, he has a clean record, it is never not a big deal when the cops are involved with Black people. Let me just start there. It can go either way on numerous occasions. And I have experienced something like this. I wasn't in a car crash, but I actually was the passenger in a car when I was in college in New Orleans. And my friend was driving. We were driving to work. We worked at the same place. And she made an illegal right turn, and we were pulled over. And when the cop approaches the car, and just for a little context, y'all, I'm a dark-skinned Black woman. She's a light-skinned Black woman. When the cop approaches the car, he pulls the gun out on the car as he approaches, and he approaches to my side and puts the gun in my face. 100% true story. It's something I don't really talk about often, but in this moment, I am brought to situations like that, which I've experienced, and then the countless things that we have seen play out on our television screens on a daily basis. Not to mention, if we actually jump back into the all-American world, y'all, Spencer has had two run-ins with the cops so far. One in which they drag Jordan and Spencer out of Jordan's car and throw them on the ground, and then one of which, when the cop was about to pull a gun on Dylan because Dylan was about to run away because he was scared. So to say that it's no big deal when the cops are going to show up and see this random car crash and see these two black teens in South Central, one light skin, one dark skin, one a female, one a male, and to just brush it off like, oh, it's whatever, it'll be fine, he'll just get a ticket if he's lucky. Like, be mindful, y'all, if he's lucky. So to me, I think the instant brush off, while no, I don't want everybody to be walking around and be pessimistic and automatically think like, oh, it's always going to go bad for black people with cops. But we still got to be aware, y'all. Like, we still got to move with a just certain amount of like our head on the swivel and caution. And in all honesty, when we can avoid this situation, we do. Like, no black person wants to interact with the cops. So to just trivialize this and say it will be no big deal, that part becomes an even bigger problem for me and for us. And this ties into why Olivia's ass is such a big problem, because she knows this. After she exposes Crenshaw Kathy and goes on her whole awakening experience and learns about her Beverly Hills bubble and wants to burst it and wants to burst everyone else's and expose everybody for the privileged life that they're living and make sure that they are tuned in and seeing what's happening outside of this, Olivia knows exactly what's up. So she knows what she's asking in this moment, but she still asks it anyway. And that's the problem for me. I do want to jump into some of the comments before I continue. Claudia K said, I feel as though Olivia asking Spencer to get in the driver's seat isn't a good idea because they can get in more trouble. Black men and cops don't mix. On top of them being in a car crash doesn't help the situation. I'm glad she confessed her love to him, though. I agree, as I just mentioned, so thank you so much for your comment. I Howe responded to Austin Black saying, since it was just a car accident and no one got hurt, Spencer will be fine if he takes the blame. He wasn't drinking, so if they run a test, he's going to pass, so no DUI or charge. Jordan got in a whole accident last season, and all that happened to him was him getting grounded. Spencer will be okay as long as they get their story straight and the police aren't on no bullcrap. I'm so glad that you noted in here that part of that is that the police have to not be on some bullcrap. But the other part that you didn't note in your comment is that Jordan, a light-skinned black man, crashed his car in Beverly Hills. Olivia crashed this car and is asking Spencer to switch spaces in South Central. That is an important fact that you cannot leave out of the conversation when you're trying to make your point. Monda Kendall said, hey, Monda girl. Okay, Liv asking him to swap seats is a huge issue for me. First and second season, Liv would never do this. So I'm not fond of who is writing for her this year. I do not believe Spencer would swap seats with her for all the reasons and concerns you may have, Erica. Lastly, Spencer needs to take 45% of the blame for the crash. You just had to throw that in there. I can't with you. Yeah, I agree. But I do think that Spencer is going to swap seats with her. Whether y'all want to believe it or not, I do think that this is going to become an issue for them because Olivia is putting him in a compromising position. Spencer is uncomfortable with cops, y'all. We have seen this on numerous occasions. And he would avoid them at any way possible. So this is going to be something that bothers him. No, this is not going to be something that breaks them. But this is going to be something that is not a good tally in the good pile for them and their relationship. Because like I said before, Olivia knows better. And this is going to compromise how Spencer feels in this moment. It's not going to make him feel good. We see him in the trailer yelling into the phone that she needs help. And I would imagine that he's doing that because, like, girl, I switched spots with you. I took this charge for you. And when I say take the charge, y'all, like, I'm from Baltimore. So it doesn't mean it's the actual charge. It might just be take responsibility. So just know that. But he's like, I took this charge for you and you out here still drinking. No, like, I'm not about to be sacrificing and I'm not about to be putting myself out there for you to continue to be doing some craziness. And thank you, Monda, so much for saying that it's an issue for you too, because I have read so many people say that it is not a problem. Z said, I don't think that's a big deal. When she asked him, she had alcohol in her system and could have gotten a DUI, whereas Spencer will probably get a ticket, which Laura will cover. It's not like she asked him to cover a murder, laugh out loud. They just hit a parked car, which I still hold her accountable for, at least 50%, and he's definitely going to do it, no questions asked. Z also went on to respond to Manda and said, I feel like people are overreacting, talking about she ruined his career, like it's not that serious. She would have gotten arrested on the spot, and I think she wanted to avoid that. And yeah, she definitely will be held accountable, as she should. I feel like if the roles were switched, Liv would have done it for Spencer, and they would literally do anything for each other. I'm going to come back to this comment because this one stuck out to me the most, but I want to touch on a few others. Alexis King said, accidentally hitting a parked car is not going to put Spencer's football career in jeopardy. He was not drinking. If they test him, it will come out negative. I don't know why people aren't getting that. Also, the reason why the crash was because Spencer distracted her, not because Olivia was drunk. Olivia should not have been drinking with the alcohol system, period. She certainly doesn't get a pass for that because it could have been much worse. And Ruthie responds to Alexis King saying this, so many people saying Spencer's football career is in danger, like what? The whole point of Olivia asking him to switch seats with her is because he doesn't have alcohol in his system like she does, so nothing would happen to him except maybe getting a ticket like you said, or the cops being trash and racist towards them. The car crash really ain't that big of a deal. It's the drinking that's the bigger issue here, and the crash is merely a way of unmasking the truth. Okay, so there's a lot to unpack there. Honestly, the reason why I'm choosing to address this is because of the dozens of comments like these that I have seen, and I haven't even gotten through the almost 1,000 of them that are gaslighting Spencer and letting Olivia off the hook for this. And I'm not saying letting Olivia off the hook for the crash. I'm saying letting Olivia off the hook for her decision to drive under the influence. And I wanted to address this for y'all, not for the defense of Spencer, because he's just a character and y'all are real people. If you get into a situation like this, do not do this. Y'all, it's one thing to love somebody down and to want to do anything for them, but when it comes to putting yourself into harm's way, and I'm sorry, but it is 2021 and we are still dealing with these ruthless, ridiculous, outrageous, racist cops. Any situation when it comes to them is putting yourself into harm's way. So I'm 100% on the side of no, Spencer does not need to swap seats with her. He needs to seem as innocent as possible when these police arrive to the scene, because it's already escalated just because of the state of where we are, y'all. Everyone is saying or giving an excuse of, well, Spencer should just do it because he doesn't have alcohol in his system, and Olivia does. That was Olivia's choice. And in all honesty, if we're going to not only just talk about racism, but we can also talk about colorism, Olivia will get a lighter fare or a lighter shake just because of how she looks. Not to mention that it's her fault. So I'm not even saying Olivia needs to take responsibility because she's light-skinned. I'm saying Olivia needs to take responsibility because she did it. And her mom is a DA. Yes, Spencer's affiliated with them, but Laura's not his mom. If Olivia takes responsibility for driving under the influence, for crashing the car, it won't be that bad for her. As y'all are saying about Spencer, it won't be that bad. Laura will help make it go away. A lot of people are like comparing it to what Jordan did and comparing it to this. And I want to speak specifically to this situation for where they're at. This is something that Olivia should be able to take responsibility for. And if you are the person who are driving drunk with someone else in the car and you feel like it's absolutely okay to ask that person to switch seats with you, then you need to think about how much you actually value that relationship with that person, because it is a lot that you are really asking of them, specifically if y'all are Black in America. Let's just be honest. And I want to double back to what Z said in reference to saying that Liv would have done it for Spencer. She wouldn't have had to, because Spencer would have never asked. And that's a very big difference here. And I'm going to get into that in a couple of other videos that I already have planned, because I have so many thoughts around that. But yeah, Spencer would have never asked her to switch spaces. Ever. Again, it's one thing to love somebody down, and I'm very happy for Spencer and Olivia to finally have confessed their love. But if you all have to be in relationships where you have to compromise yourself this way and make these type of sacrifices and do so on a regular basis, and I'm saying on a regular basis because I also believe that this is foreshadowing for some things that are going to continually happen, because Olivia is not in a good place to make good decisions right now in her life. So I don't think that this is the end of stuff like this. If you are in this type of situation and these things come up, then this is a relationship that you probably shouldn't be in this moment, because the person is asking too much of you. You should not have to choose anything like this in this situation. Making the person that you love have to make this particular choice in this situation is not love. And again, respectfully, I said what I said. All right, y'all, but now it is your turn and your time. Drop down into the comment section below and tell me what you're thinking. Tell me what you're feeling. I am pretty sure that 50% of y'all at least are going to come from my head and like, Erica, I don't agree. You're exaggerating all of this other jazz. All I can say is you can disagree with me and we can still be friends. Just keep it respectful. Keep it cute. And for everybody that I pointed out in this video, it was definitely not to call you out or anything like that. I really just wanted to have a dialogue around all of what y'all were talking about. And I use y'all as an example. I definitely receive what y'all are saying. I just pray that you're never in this type of situation and nobody ever asks this of you, because I want the best for all of y'all. Y'all's my people and I really, really love y'all. But again, let's talk it out in the comment section down below. You made it this far, so make sure that you like this video and share it with another All-American fan. You know, send the video out to your little friends and let's all be friends. If you are new here, you can go ahead and click the subscribe button and join the tribe. I promise you are going to love it here. We have the most lit conversations. As you can see, like, we be going back and forth. I put the comments in this video. You know, it gets real. It gets, you know, interesting. It gets very, very chatty in the comment section, and you should definitely join us. Just a reminder, we are doing season one rewatches live every Saturday at 6 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. We are using an app called Teleparty so that we can all watch the exact same episode at the exact same time, and y'all will be live with me. If you want to sign up for that, the link is in the description box down below. And we already did our one this Saturday. It was amazing. I absolutely love y'all so much. We get to kiki and cut up and enjoy one of our favorite shows together. It is so dope. So if you want to get in on that for this coming Saturday or any of the Saturdays to come, we're doing it up until April 12th when season 3 returns. So click the link in the description box. I'm your girl Erica Vane, and I post new All-American videos every day, sometimes twice a day, and you should have been subscribed already, so I ain't even gonna tell y'all that. Make sure you watch the All-American playlist, catch up on all the videos that you missed. Your girl done dropped 70 videos in the last month and a half, so I know that there's 1, 2, 3, or 4 that you might have missed that you need to go ahead and catch up on, so go ahead and check out the playlist. Also, you can watch my last All-American video here. See you in the next one. Bye. I'm hiding just behind the stars, but how come the stars don't shine when it's day? How come the sky at night makes me this way?